I have a motion to recess the meeting.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
May I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Palafis. Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. This meeting is now recessed.
I'd like to call the first meeting of the month to order. Can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Sure. Trustee Gata.
Present.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Present.
Trustee Mills.
Present.
Trustee Newell.
Present.
Trustee Palafis.
Present.
Trustee Stanton.
Present.
Mayor McLeod.
Present. Trustee Gata, can you lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance?
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Everybody can remain standing. I'd like to do a moment for silence for all those who passed in the horrific events of this past week. Thank you very much. We've called this meeting to order to do the promotions. So with the leave of the board, I'll go to President's Report. And Chief, I believe you have some business to conduct here.
Mayor and the board, with your approval, I would like to present some officers for promotion. First, we have Sergeant
Julie Golden.
Your family, Julie.
Nice. Can I introduce your family?
Sure. This is my husband, Jeff, my daughter, Paige, my son, Luke, and my other son, Luke. Or, I'm sorry, my son, John, and my youngest son.
Yeah. Well, this will be your last few moments as a sergeant, soon to be Lieutenant Julie Golden. I, Julie Golden.
I, Julie Golden. Having been appointed to the office of.
Police Lieutenant.
Police Lieutenant.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
In the County of Cook and King.
The County of Cook and King.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States. The
Constitution of the State of Illinois.
Constitution of the State of Illinois.
I will faithfully discharge.
I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of Police Lieutenant.
Of Police Lieutenant.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations, Lieutenant. Need your sign. Very good.
Thank you.
Now, who's going to pin the badge on, I wonder?
My daughter will be.
Okay, there you go. Nice badge, huh? Nice job. I'm going to shake hands with all the... Oh, thanks, Jeff.
He's fired. I was going to go see him.
Jeff, congratulations. That takes sides and everything, huh?
Yeah. I'm going to stay with my grandma, man. Sorry. Go this way. Perfect. All right. We'll go one, two, three. Take a couple. They're easy.
Great. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Mayor and Village Board, with your approval, I'd like to present Officer Joe Goback for promotion to Sergeant.
Why don't you introduce everybody, Joe?
Sure. My wife Candace, my mom Doris, and my kids Anthony, Audrey, Samantha, Skylar, and Abby.
Wow.
Yeah.
Looks pretty happy, doesn't he?
I, Joseph Goldbeck.
I, Joseph Goldbeck.
Having been appointed to the office of?
Have been appointed to the office of?
Police Sergeant.
Police Sergeant.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
In the County of Cook and Kane.
In the County of Cook and Kane.
Do solemnly swear or affirm?
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution?
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States?
Of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of Illinois?
The Constitution of the State of Illinois.
That I will faithfully discharge?
That I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office?
The duties of the office.
Of Police Sergeant?
Of Police Sergeant.
According to the best of my ability?
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations, Sergeant Goldbeck. You have an absolutely lovely badge. Who do you want to put that on you?
My lovely wife.
Ready.
I'm so proud of you.
Nice job.
For coming out today.
Nice to see you.
You must be proud.
Thank you. Good job, ma'am.
His father was a captain in Chicago.
Oh, great. It's in the blood. Let's get more towards the center, Joe.
Okay. Yep, this will work here. Well.
Yeah.
All right. One, two, three. Take a couple. One, two, three. Gotcha. Congratulations.
Yeah. Mayor, Village Board, with your approval, I would also like to present Officer Brian Savage for promotion to Sergeant.
You want to introduce everybody, Brian?
Yeah. This is my Uncle Dave, my mother, Virginia, my aunt, Juanita, and my cousin, DJ.
Thank you for all coming here tonight. You look pretty happy, too.
Thanks.
Hi, Brian Savage.
Hi, Brian Savage.
Having been appointed to the office.
Having been appointed to the office.
Of Police Sergeant.
Of Police Sergeant.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
In the Village of Hoffman Estates.
The County of Cook and Kane.
And the County of Cook and Kane.
Do solemnly swear or affirm?
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution?
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States?
Of the United States.
The Constitution?
The Constitution.
Of the State of Illinois?
Of the State of Illinois.
That I will faithfully discharge?
That I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office?
The duties of the office.
Of Police Sergeant?
Of Police Sergeant.
According to the best of my ability?
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations, Sergeant! Yeah.
Nice badge. A lot of you guys have had one of these, don't you?
I think so.
You guys and gals? Who do you want to pin it on?
My mother and my uncle.
Come on up. They glued that one together.
All right.
Chief.
I actually think there's better resolution on this than the modern calendar. But I'm thinking. These costs are.
It's teamwork. Oh, teamwork.
There we go.
Hey, yeah. Good job.
We're good here.
Which way am I going?
All right, nope, everybody's great. Okay, 1, 2, 3, to another. 1, 2, 3. Great, congratulations.
Can we get all three of the officers who were sworn in this evening to come on up? Get a group picture? We'll get them first, then the chief. Let's get them first, chief, and then with you too, okay?
Take a couple here.
I'll move over this one.
We need all the food.
Just any short people.
Okay, now we're good. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Do it, Diller. 1, 2, 3. Good.
Chief, you want to get in here?
Which side are you going to go on?
Perfect.
Whatever side he wants. He's the chief.
Now I need to rearrange. Okay, here we go. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Do another couple. Good.
Hey, congratulations. Great to see so many of their colleagues come out in support of them. It's wonderful. At this point, I'd ask for a motion to recess this meeting and go back to the General Administration personnel. Can you call the roll? I need a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis?
Aye.
Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
Aye.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Aye. We are recessed until the end of the four committee meetings. Thank you.
Ready? I'd like to have a roll call to reestablish quorum for the General Administration and Personnel Committee.
Present. Vice Chairman Stanton.
Present.
Trustee Mills.
Present.
Trustee Newell.
Present.
Trustee Gata.
Present.
Mayor McLeod.
Present.
Thank you. We do have a quorum. At this time, I'd like to entertain a motion for approval of the minutes of June 13th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
Are there any additions or corrections?
One has to be open.
Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. We need a roll call.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'd like to have a roll call, please.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Abstain.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. The motion is approved. Under new business, we have seven items. Item number one, discussion regarding legislative update. Mr. Norris, would you like to give a recap of?
Sure. And this is old news by now, but the state legislature and the governor did pass an interim stopgap budget. By no means was it balanced. The good news for municipalities is that the most important pass-through revenues that we need to for our operations were appropriated for the full year, for the full state fiscal year. It is expected that sometime after the November election that the legislature will again take up the issue of budget.
That's all I have.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions from the board on this item? Item number two, discussion regarding personnel policy manual update. Mr. Norris, would you like to expound on that, or Mr. Seeger, would you like to talk?
I'll certainly start it off. The village undertook a complete rewrite of its personnel policy manual in 2004, and then in 2011, it was updated. It was time for another update 5 years post. As part of the resolution that approves the personnel policy manual, the village board directs that if there is a actual change in law, that staff is authorized to make that change at the time. But even though we kept current with those changes, there's a lot of other things that go on in personnel law. There's court cases and decisions that come down. There are changes in philosophies by our labor council about what should and should not be in a personnel policy manual. So you have received a copy of the new draft personnel policy manual that highlights in color three different types of changes. Those changes that were legal in nature, those changes that were policy, and those changes that where there was just that were just changes. And the memorandum you have in front of you goes through in detail the policy level changes. There are no benefit changes and no benefit enhancements. These are merely clarifications, wording change, changes, and again, legal changes as recommended by our outside counsel. And Mr. Seeger and or I would be happy to respond to any questions that you might have.
From the board. I would just like to add that I know a lot of work went into this this policy update, manual update, and I want to thank you, Mr. Seeger, Mr. Norris, and your staff who worked many, many hours on updating this, having a pretty good knowledge of a personnel policy from employers that I've had in the past. I know that this is a very, very complete personnel policy, and just thank you for all the work that you've done on it, because it was quite a lot. Are you looking for a motion then for approval?
Yes. We're a motion to recommend this to the village board for approval.
Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Well, second.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, I'd like to have a roll call vote, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Chairman Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. The motion is approved. Item number three, discussion regarding design concepts for redesign of village website.
Hi.
Would you like to give us an overview, update?
Yes.
You're not on.
Hold on. That's my fault. It's on now.
Okay.
I was trying to get the machine to come on.
Sorry, I'm trying
there
to.
There you go.
Whoops. Okay. You have in your packets a slideshow that is just an example of some things that staff had put together in assessment, initial assessment of potential design for our new look of our village website. So I was just going to go through and review that for you while we're waiting for this to come up. Why I tried to come up here initially. Okay, so we looked at a group of 16 staff, looked at examples of websites that are already monitored and managed by Vision Internet. So we have a contract with Vision. We're fairly happy, at least on a staff side, with editing the website. And we entered into an agreement the board did in 2013 for a redesign of the village website, the front-end look. So we looked at a variety of websites, taking into consideration the colors that were used, the shapes, the size of images, where features were on the website. And we looked also at some of the content that was featured, specific features. How quickly do objects move across the screen? Is there scrolling text? Are there a lot of images or videos playing? The level of detail, how big the menus are in these websites. So we just tried to get a variety of examples for you, and I'm looking today to get a little bit of feedback on what you like, what you might not like to see, if you want a style that's more modern, if you want something that has a homier feel, whatever the case may be, that the village board is interested in seeing as a representation of the village. It's definitely.
Can you see if you can get that to reload? It's
yeah.
It's not taking the color for some reason.
Okay. Maybe if I reopen it. There. So this looks very familiar. It's our website. I tried to just give an example screenshot. We have kind of a tighter menu, and then on the side you see how the navigation column, the bar to the right, shows our menu. So it's a column menu. You have to scroll down to a particular page that you're looking for, and then you would select something to the right. That looks a little bit different than, for example, the city of Ames, Iowa, and their website. It's a little bit cleaner, I guess, than our website. You have a large picture and then a couple of color blocks. As you scroll down the page, there's not a lot of content below what you see here. So it's a very horizontal looking page. And here's an example of a menu that looks different than ours. So you have this very open look where all of your menu choices are shown to you right off the bat. So if you're looking for government, you'll see all of the departments at once and their submenus. So these menus can get very large, or we can limit the content. It just depends on the style or the look that you're looking for. The insert is just an example of one of their commission pages. So it's just identifying what that inside page will look like. As I described in the menu, the content of our website isn't going to change dramatically. It's going to look a lot like it does now. The templates look a lot like they do now, or they will look a lot like they do now. So it's really about the colors. It's about the general feel and appearance of how we navigate through the website. So the Village of Bartlett is another example. People tended to like this. Our group of staff liked it. They like the simple color schemes, the clean colors. And again, it's a very horizontal page. There's not much content below the meetings and the news functions. There's a scrolling bar, so you can see the e-notifications, online payments. All that's kind of laid out right in front there for you. It also has a menu that drops down kind of like the Ames site has, where it's a very big menu. You can see an example of this on the second page for Bartlett. It has the zoomed in part that shows your latest news, which we have now on our site. And then another example of a very, very big menu. So it depends on what kind of look you're looking for. Of the city of Sedona, Arizona, which is a very dramatically different kind of look from our current site. Uses different color schemes, a very open big picture, but it doesn't take up the whole screen. One problem with a very, very large picture is that you need to have a very high quality resolution to the picture. So we may need some professional photography, maybe not, depending on how big we want those photos to be and how much space we want them to take up. These are just examples of what the Sedona site looks like. The pages look very much like our current web pages look and how they probably would look similar. And then a neat function was just to show you that we can incorporate Google language so people can select whatever language it is that they speak. And there's a, you know, enormous list of options for people to include. That was a feature that was suggested as something to add to our website. And then the final two slides are just showing an example of Roswell, Georgia. This is a very different look, again, because it has a very large picture that fills the entire screen, a kind of transparent sort of look. But you do have nice menu options right there on the home screen. Again, it's horizontal, not much scrolling down. And these are insets that kind of zoom in on particular functions. So the news items, the events will change as you click on different pieces of that site. The page was just an example of how it looks very similar to our page. It's just the menus on the right-hand side, which we could do if you like that look. And then finally, Scottsdale, Arizona is another page that people liked. It is not a Vision Internet site. But it is something that attracted people because of the clean lines, clean colors, crisp menus. And this offered a lot of very clear navigation. So we can strive for that in our design. And finally, we have the city of Longmont, Colorado. Again, it's just a very different look. Some people liked the big search bar in the middle. Some people did not like that. And it gives you little option kind of selection boxes for your news, for your menus, for your services and events. So I'm looking for any feedback about what sites you might really like, what you don't like at all. And then we can take a collective summary of this, and then we can either reintroduce it to the board or in a memo format, or we'll just submit it to Vision in the fall and see what designs they come up with.
Thank you, Ashley.
Thank you.
Comments from the board?
Trustee Newell.
Just a couple things. I like the idea of the languages, mm-hmm. Since we do have a diverse community, so it's easier for them to read. I do like the cleaner a little bit on the front page. It's nice to have the tabs, but then we have a little bit too much, I think, in between now. We keep adding, so it looks a little cluttered. And rather than explaining, say, LinkedIn, Facebook, and all that, everybody knows the signs nowadays. Just maybe just put the signs somewhere.
Okay.
So that's all I have.
Thank you. Other discussion? Other comments? Trustee Stanton.
It seems like in the report that we received that Sedona was the most liked of all of them. And then Ames came in second, Bartlett third. Is that the way I'm reading it, basically?
Yes. Funnily enough, wow. Interestingly enough, Bartlett was either at the top of the list or at the bottom of the list. So it depended on what individuals were looking at and how they, I guess, what they liked about it or didn't like. So yes, it was kind of towards the middle because it was neither at the top, either at the top or the bottom. And then Sedona, again, was just, I think, unique. It looks different and bright colored. That was appreciated. There's a very specific area that you would look, those boxes that are kind of gem-toned for menus so that 9 choices fit very well within a small space. It wasn't hard to identify what was in those boxes, in those links, I guess.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing something like Sedona. Okay. I'd like to see it before we approve it, obviously, too.
And you will. You definitely will. It'll come back with designs later in the fall, probably.
And Trustee Mills. Well,
the one thing I liked about the Ames one is that the one page, the second page of it, it has different classifications listed, and it might make it a little easier trying to find what you're looking for. I know the way ours is now, you have to keep pulling down tabs and go into tabs and that, and it you get frustrated when you're trying to find something. So I do like where we'd maybe have some pages of just comments, questions of topics that they might be looking for, that the general public might be looking for. I mean, they all have little elements to them that would work a little better. I like, on the Sedona page, I like the way they have all the squares up on the top part there where you have some different areas you can look at and pull up. But it's a lot of work. There's a lot of things to look at.
Yes.
They all kind of run together, I'm sure, after a while. That's all.
Thank you.
Well, one thing in changing, mm-hmm. people that are accustomed to our website and they know where things go or what they're looking for, and then all of a sudden we start changing it, that I don't know about that, but I agree with Trustee Newell. As far as the languages, yes. And with the Sedona, just like Trustee Mills said, that box there does make it easier and quicker where you can go to what you're looking for. But basically, I still like ours, the way it's laid out. That's it.
I feel like your comment reminds me of when you go to a grocery store and when they rearrange the grocery store, and just when you think you had it all down, they change it all. And then you find that you liked it better after the change because they've put a lot of thought into it, and it's easier for you now. So maybe it's like our website.
Go ahead. I just thought of one other thing. Another thing that would be good on here is if we actually put a calendar page. Mm. Now you have to look for upcoming events here and there and there and there. But if actually one screen was actually the calendar for maybe that month or the following month, mm-hmm. so people at a glance could see what's coming up, similar to what we put into the newsletter.
I think that's like on the Sedona page. They have the calendar right on the front. I like the Bartlett calendar or the website to me with the boxes across the top where it looks like you can scroll left to right. To me, it just looks very easy, ease in navigation. But there's a lot of good points out of each one of them. I think simpler is the better, as simple to use as possible, especially for our residents that are not completely computer savvy. Ease of use without all the fancy pictures and hard to find navigation is going to be something to keep in mind.
The words KISS, K-I-S-S, always works very, very well.
Yes.
Are there any other comments from the board then? Hearing none, I would like to entertain a motion so you can move forward and...
Great.
Do you need a motion at this point?
I don't think so.
Just discussion?
Just discussion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very much for your input. I appreciate it.
We'll look forward to you coming back to us then with your
design ideas, concepts.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
Item number 4, request approval to dispose of village records that have exceeded their state-required retention period.
So moved.
Second.
Rachel, would you like to give us an update?
Sure, I can address this item. This is our annual disposal of village records. There's nothing on this list that hasn't been there before. We've gotten into a really good pattern where every year we're able to dispose of what we're legally allowed to do so, and that's all that's included on this list.
Thank you. Are there any questions from the board? Seeing none, I would like to have a roll call vote, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Motion passes. Item number 5, request acceptance of cable TV monthly report.
So moved.
Second.
Questions from the board? Hearing none, I'd like to have a roll call vote, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee, I'm sorry, Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. Motion carries. Item number 6, request acceptance of Human Resources Management Monthly Report.
So moved.
Second.
Questions from the board? Hearing none, we may have a roll call vote, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
The motion carries. Item number 7, request acceptance of Legislative Operations and Outreach Monthly Report.
So moved.
Second.
I would like to thank Jen for putting this together. May we have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Item number 3, President's Report.
I'll wait for the board meeting, Madam Chair.
Thank you. We do not have any other items or items in review, so I would like to entertain a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
May we have a roll call, please?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. The motion carries, and this meeting is adjourned.
Cool. Boy, again, fading in and out here. I'd like to call the Transportation and Road Improvement Committee for the Village of Hoffman Estates on this June 11th, 2016 to order. Roll call, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Present.
Oh, I'm sorry, I've got the wrong one. Chairman Stanton.
I'm present.
Vice Chairman Mills.
I'm present.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Present.
Trustee Newell.
Present.
Trustee Gata.
Present.
Mayor McLeod.
Present.
Thank you. We have a quorum. Looking for approval of the minutes of June 13th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. Anybody notice any corrections or deletions? Hearing none and seeing none, all those in favor say, whoops, roll call, please. Caught myself.
Caught yourself there. Good job. Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Abstain.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. Minutes passed. New business. Request acceptance of the Transportation Division monthly report.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. Anybody notice any here? Mike, do you want to make any mention of anything?
I'd be happy to answer any questions. The one thing I did want to note is the test of the O'Hare rotation, runway rotation, is in effect now. There's information up on our website about that, about how people can fill out a survey on anything that they've observed, as well as continue to submit any noise complaints. Those are two different activities that people should do.
Where are the runway, where do we expect the noise to occur in Hoffman Estates?
Well, it's really when the northwest diagonally oriented runway is part of the rotation plan. By the time the planes typically get this far out, they're well above 3,000 feet, which is the cutoff where the airport actively tracks a lot of the complaints. They log everything, but there are fewer, higher the plane gets, the less the noise impact, of course. The point is that people may see more planes over the area, but that doesn't necessarily relate to increased noise. If it is, that's what the airport wants to hear.
Sure. And where would they see the planes, though? Would it be We won't say what kind of comment that is.
I know.
Would they be going east, west, north, south? Which, you know, would they be
both? They could be going, yeah, either or any, because they stay on the heading that's oriented northwest until they reach a certain altitude, and then they can peel off and go in whatever direction their destination takes.
It's both for landings and departures.
Okay.
So they're either going to be going from the southeast to the northwest or from the northwest to the southeast. But as we have seen and heard, sometimes they get in a pattern, they curve in, and it's a little bit different. And again, this is rotating. So that runway is only going to be, I think when we looked at Mike, it was like every 4 to 5 rotations.
Right.
Before this runway gets used. So
right.
That's actually part of what they want to find out. Does the rotation cause more complaints, less complaints, those type of things? And not just from our area. They're looking obviously metropolitan
sure.
area wide. And it's only really between the hours of 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. So
most people will be sleeping.
That's the thought, hope. Hopefully, unless they're very light sleepers, right?
Yeah. Trustee Gata?
Where we are over Hoffman Estates, they call it the dump zone, and that's like 10,000 feet. So they bring them down to 10,000, and then they start the curve to go into O'Hare. So the noise won't be as loud as if they were coming in for a landing. And they're like, you know, 3,000 feet off the ground. Then you really notice it. Right. But over Hoffman Estates, it's so high, it should not make any difference whatsoever to the residents.
Good to hear. Anybody else? Okay. We have a motion and a second on the Transportation Division monthly report. A roll call, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Assume we are waiting for the board meeting?
You assume correctly.
Okay. Well, we don't have anything in other, I will mention that we are scheduled, I believe, to have a special Transportation Division monthly report next week with committee meetings, correct?
Committee. That's correct.
Okay. Then I'm looking for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Stanton.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
We're adjourned.
Thank you. I'd like to call to order the Planning, Building, and Zoning Committee meeting for July 11th, 2016. Could we please take a roll call?
Trustee Palafis.
Present.
Chairman Mills.
Present.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Present.
Trustee Stanton.
Present.
Trustee Newell.
Present.
Trustee Gata.
Present.
Mayor McLeod.
Present.
Thank you. I look for a motion to approve the minutes of June 13th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any changes, corrections? Seeing none, please take a roll call.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Mills.
Here. Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Abstain.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Thank you. Now I'll look for a motion to approve the special meeting of June 20th, 2016.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any corrections or changes to that one? Seeing none, please call and take a roll call.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye.
Under new business this evening, number one, a request by Route 21 Auto Wash and Detail for a courtesy review of a proposed car wash redevelopment of the existing car wash located at 105 East Gulf Road. Petitioner here, please come forward. And we ask that you identify yourselves for the record.
Who's Hello, my name is David Lieberman.
Tim Upfer.
John Swark with DDCA Architects.
Okay, who's the main spokesman then? Is that Tim?
Dave is going to.
Okay, well, Tim, you are the one who signed the statement of understanding.
Yes.
That you understand your appearance tonight before the Planning, Building, and Zoning Committee shall not constitute any Village Board endorsement, support, or implied approval of the subject property, and that you also understand that the final project approval or denial shall only occur through the official village board action.
I do.
Thank you. And you realize that this is not a planned commission hearing, so this is just strictly a courtesy review.
Yes.
Thank you. And we ask that you stay on the microphone, too. Go right ahead now.
Hi. Good evening, board members. My name is David Lieberman. This is my partner, Tim. And we currently own and operate six full car wash and detail facilities in the suburban areas of Cook County. Basically, what we do is we go into old sites and we redesign them and enhance them and enhance the property. Tonight, we're looking at one that's on Golf Road that has been built, I think it's going on just about 60 years without any renovations or improvements or updates to it. I don't know if you are familiar with it or not, but in my opinion, it's an eyesore for the Village of Hoffman Estates, and it does not enhance the Golf Road corridor, to say the least. What we would like to do to it is we would like to basically totally rebuild it. Do we have any plans we can show them?
They were submitted, I believe.
Do you see the plans for the architectural renderings for the way that they would look? Right, yes. We want to rebuild it. We want to invest about $3 million into this project, and we think that it definitely will enhance the Golf Road property as well as for the village. But in doing so, the problem that we're running into is this being that's a 60-year-old project does not meet current village codes in many, many regards. So basically, there's really two options before the village, which is one, to leave it the way it is in existence because they don't have the setbacks and such and so forth that is now to meet the village codes, so they don't need to meet them because they're grandfathered in, but I don't think that serves anybody's best interest. Or two, what we propose to do and we like to do is we'd like not to have to have those setbacks that currently meet the code and be able to provide the project that we designed and that you're looking at right now. We wouldn't be using any more of the space that's already there, but because it's a narrow and small piece of land, we basically need every inch of it. We're prepared to invest $3 million in this project, and we think it's in the village's best interest, the board's best interest, and our best interest to take this 60-year-old building, renovate it, and make it look nice and beautify it. So we do need the help of the village board, and some of the things we have no problem with, like there's no sprinkler system in it. Of course, we're going to put a brand new sprinkler system in, bring new water service. Things of that nature are not the problem. The main problem is that setbacks, that is what, 10 feet? Yeah. I think 10 feet?
Yeah, there's several comments in the village. Yeah,
that where they need 10 feet setbacks. And part of our proposal, if you look at on the sheet, we have 8 self-serve vacuum bays that the customers pull up and they vacuum themselves, and then they go in for a car wash and they leave. That's up along the property line fence, which is currently there. If we did a 10-foot setback from there, that would wipe out the vacuum area. We couldn't do the project because without vacuums, it doesn't work. It's up. There's a fence right there on the property.
Still next to residential.
Yes, there's a residential piece of property. So it's been like that for 60 years. We're just proposing that if you can leave it the way it's been, we can do our project, and I think the village and us and everyone will benefit, and residents of Hoffman Estates as well.
Well, it's not up to us to make that determination tonight anyway, but you can get input from the board at this time. Anything else you're looking at? And there was a whole list of items that would have to be met, correct, staff?
We tried to highlight, obviously we haven't gotten any detailed operational reviews or sound reviews or anything like that, but this list highlights the kind of the obvious physical geometric comments that would be issues or potential waivers that would be needed on the site. And there are obviously quite a number of them, given that our typical approach to redevelopment of a property is to try and, while sometimes waivers may be justified, we do try to bring the property at least closer to current development standards.
Right, and as I said, the one concern right away I had was regarding the vacuums close to residential, since you're doing it right on that line. Board members, anyone else up here have any comments or concerns at this point? Trustee Gata.
Yes, you say you have six other locations on that?
Yes, sir.
Where are they located?
We have one, our newest one is in Wheeling on Milwaukee Road, north of Dundee and south of Lake Cook, right next to Pete Miller Steakhouse. I don't know if you're familiar with that or not. That was another blight that was in a TIF district, and it was run down, 45, 50-year-old dilapidated building. I don't know if you've seen it or since we've renovated it and redone it. It looks very similar to that. In fact, we actually got $50,000 in grant money from the village, for renovating it and putting a new facade on there and making it look beautiful, facade to make it look beautiful. And we want to do the same thing for the one on Golf Road.
Okay.
So Wheeling is one. Another one is on the corner of Lake Cook and Hicks Road in Palatine, right on the corner. That's two. We have one in Mundelein on Route 60, a half mile east of 83. We have one in Algonquin on Algonquin, just a half a block east of Randall Road, which is four. We have one in Lombard on Roosevelt Road, which is exactly 1 mile east to 355. And then we have one in Oak Lawn on 95th Street. That's 2 miles east of 294.
Very good. Thank you.
A couple of questions. What would be your hours of operation?
On days that it is not raining or snowing, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Normally,
during the week, about two to three, and then on the weekend, four.
And out of these many issues that have been brought up by the village, the main thing you're looking at would be regarding the setbacks? Are there any other issues?
They put down that they had some concerns about how the traffic flow would work in us building the detail shop, the five-bay detail shop, but we have six of these in existence now, and basically we direct the traffic, and we've never had a problem at any of the stores. We just control the traffic. Our detailers, after the cars come out of the tunnel, have to come at detail bay, we direct them in, we direct them out, and it's never an issue. Has never been an issue for us. So basically, the issue of the setbacks is
the biggest problem. A lot of vacuums.
And to allow the vacuums, the biggest problem that we have is the setbacks. We have no problem putting a sprinkler system in, updating the water main. We have no problem updating everything in there. It's just the setbacks is our biggest problem. And we can assure the village that there isn't any traffic concerns, even though it's noted in there, as far as how customers pull in and out, because we've never had an issue with that at all.
Okay. Anyone else up there?
There's some talk about cross easement to parcel 2, and in the picture that I see here is like almost a driveway with greenery next to your building and then going to parcel 2 and maybe going out of parcel 2. What is your idea?
Yes, originally when we met with Kevin Kramer, right? When we met with Kevin, we talked about that we would like to have a cross easement agreement with the two vacant parcels that are to the west of it that would lead to the access road into the Jewel Shopping Center. Kevin said that he was all in favor of that, and he would support that because it only makes sense. They believed in having cross easement agreements. So we went, based on that meeting, we had the cross easement agreement. Since then, we've been told by staff that currently Sterling, the group that owns the Jewel, they haven't closed on the land, so it's still owned by the village, but they don't want to commit to any easement without Sterling's approval or something that would benefit them. So for the point of this, we're willing to do it without the easement. We just thought it would be good for both parties to be able to have a cross easement agreement to help the traffic flow. It is not a necessary part of our project. It's not a deal breaker, so to speak.
Okay.
I mean, we like it, but it's definitely not a deal breaker. The vacuums, on the other hand, we do that for our concept. It doesn't work without self-serve vacuums.
Let me ask you about the other sites that you just mentioned. Are they about as constrained as this site is?
Some are larger. Some are about the same size. Lombard's a very similar site. It's constrained very, very similar. And Algonquin is a little bit bigger. The most similar one we would have would be our Route 38 Lombard location. Yeah, Wheeling is a little bit tight too. They're all very similar.
Okay. Frankly, I don't have much of a problem with the vacuums where they are.
And maybe you should explain the concept of how the vacuums work.
Yes. I don't know if any of you have been to any of my car washes. I don't know if you've gone through the concept of a $3 car wash or up, but basically you can have an outside car wash for $3. You stay in your vehicle. Basically, the customers come up, they pull in, they vacuum their own cars if they like to do so. Then they pull up to the kiosk, they select their wash, anywhere from a $3 wash to a $12 tire wheel cleaner, triple foam wax, Rain-X, that type of thing, tire shine, and then they exit the tunnel and they're done. Then we also have what's called a flex serve, that if a customer wants us to vacuum their cars and do the windshields with Windex and the inside of the windows and the door jams and the trunk, then they pull into the detail bay, and our detailers give them a full service car wash as opposed to a drive-through type car wash. So the customers just pull in, they go through, they select a wash, they enter the tunnel, they're in there for about a minute and a half, and they're out, the car's out the door.
All right, thanks for the information.
Any of you ever been to any of our car washes?
No.
And the vacuums are free.
We will.
And the vacuums are free of charge to customers, yes, that's a good point.
Trustee Vandenberg?
On the site plan that we have, I don't see any place for, like, employee parking, and I know you said you'd have, like, three or four employees.
Well, no, I said we'd have usually, during the week, 2 to 3 employees on weekdays and up to 4 employees on the weekend. So as far as employee parking goes, how many spots do we have, John?
Yeah, we have 6.
We have 6 spaces.
We have 6 spaces for employee parking.
Okay. Where are they located?
On the, 2 on the back side of the proposed addition. And then along the, would that be the west property line, where it says the old exit entry to be removed. Just kind of parallel parking back there.
Okay.
Unlike typical car washes, you now see the full service car washes where you have like 20 people out there drying cars. This car wash does not have anyone at the end of the tunnel. It's basically self-serve. You go to the kiosk, you go through.
When the car comes out of the tunnel, they just drive away. The car, we have heaters and blowers, and the car comes out basically 98% dry without human hands touching it or scratching the vehicles, et cetera.
And the vacuum is important. Note that the vacuum machine is inside the building. So you don't hear, like, if you're doing the 50-cent vacuum with all the noise, you don't have that noise. You just have a hose with suction on it. So it's not very noisy to the neighbors.
That makes more sense.
Thank you.
Anything else?
No.
When you're talking about the detailing, is that all in one day? Do you have extra, those where the 3 employees are basically going to be?
Yes, we usually have one person in the kiosk, and then depending on how busy it is, the person in the kiosk also guides the cars in. They greet the customer, they walk over, they go like this, mm-hmm. They say, put your car in neutral, foot off the brake, hands off wheel, they press a button, and that's the end of it, the car mm-hmm. goes through. On a busier day, and it's usually only in the winter, maybe 40, 50 days a year when it's busy, you'll have actually one person dedicated greeting, another person dedicated loading cars, and then one person in the detail shop to do a detail and full serves. Normally in the course of a day, you might do 1 or 2 details if that would be a very busy day, but normally it's full serves that they're there to do, which take about 10 to 12 minutes, maybe 14 minutes. We vacuum the inside for the customer, we wipe down the car, we use Windex on the windows. After 12 minutes, they're done. So we usually have one dedicated detailer, usually one in the kiosk, and then if we're really busy, we have a third person who's in the tunnel loading cars.
Okay. And the cars can go through one after another. You don't have to wait for one to finish before.
No.
It's a constantly moving.
You load. It's a constantly moving conveyor.
We have one similar to that in town, right?
Yes. It just constantly keeps moving.
So when you pay at the kiosk, there's a sensor in the pavement mm-hmm. that knows your car as it goes through to the car wash entrance.
Yeah.
And they're in a line going that way, knowing what car wash you paid for.
Okay. All right. Other questions up here? Trustee Newell.
I was just curious if it was like the soft cloth or the rotating brushes.
It's actually a material called Neoglide, which is kind of like a soft sponge, okay? Contrary to popular belief, car washes are soft cloth, do not scratch cars. That's a myth. What scratches cars is at the end of the car wash, most car washes, including the one that's there, they don't have enough equipment to get the car cleaned properly. So when they have the six guys at the end with the towels, quote, drying the cars, unquote, they are drying them, but what they're really doing is taking off the dirt that was left in the car wash. And when you do that, when you have a towel and you have grit on it and you're going across the surface, guess what you're doing, trustee? You're scratching it. The machines and the cloth themselves do not put scratches onto cars.
Okay, thank you.
Are these the actual prices of your detailing service that you have on the prints we received? The $89, $69,
$139.
Wow, you have good eyes.
Sounds about right. But I know I don't need to look at the menu. What would your question be?
Well, how long do those types of detailings take?
Okay, an interior detail takes about 45 minutes to an hour. A clay bar in 21 takes about 30 to 40 minutes. A full detail where we use a carpet extractor to extract the soil from the carpeting, do the interior and the exterior, takes about an hour and 45 minutes to 2 hours.
And how often do you have those type of detailings that you would need five bays?
Well, no, the reason why there's five bays is for the full-serve customers, trustee. We may have two or three customers that come in within 5 or 10 minutes of each other that they want a full-serve. Like I said before, the full details are maybe one or two a day, so we have a bay or two that they stay in, and then we have two or three bays open for the customers that are coming to get their full-serve. So that's
okay.
Much more frequent part of our business.
All right. Anyone else? Well, it looks like you got some work to do with staff yet on these concerns that you'd have to work out with them before we see if it comes forward to us. Yes, Peter.
I believe there may be someone one of the adjacent neighbors in the public.
Also. There's someone in the audience? Please come forward then. And just remember, this is not the planning and zoning hearing, but we'll be happy to have your comments.
Hi.
My name is Sam McMatch, and I'm the property owner immediately east with the two residential homes, and I have great concerns about the project, to be honest with you. I think the property is it's just not conducive to a development.
Stay by the microphone.
I'm sorry, I think it's not conducive to a development like they want to propose here. You know, it's such a small site, there's traffic issues, the noise with the vacuum on adjacent to my property. I just don't think that it's the right use for that location. It might have been a great car wash 60 years ago, but it doesn't fit there now. I think it'd be a mistake to be married to it for another 60 years.
Okay. Thank you very much. Staff has your name and address, so you can be notified when this does go to planning and zoning.
Question to staff. I don't think it was in the report.
Sure.
Comprehensive plan.
Use the mic, though.
Sorry, the comprehensive plan along Gulf Road?
Yes.
For the houses to the east. What is that designated as?
It's residential.
As comprehensive?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Thanks.
Has been and always will be. It's right there.
Well, until and or less the covenants are addressed.
Right.
There's
covenants
on those
areas. Okay. Anyone else? All right. As I was saying, it looks like you've got some work to do with staff yet. Scheduled to go before zoning and plan commission. So that's people for you to work with right now, and we wish you luck with the project.
Trustee Mills, if we could, we just need to clarify, because if you choose to move forward and put a contract, hopefully contingent upon local government approvals, so you're not getting too far out of your skis.
We already have that. Already have that in place.
It will really be up to the planning and and zoning commission to determine whether or not the setback issue is something
right.
They feel is appropriate for a waiver, and then they recommend that to the board. Staff, as part of looking at the properties, we have to cite what the current codes are. It's up to that Planning and Zoning Commission and the board to determine whether or not they should be waived, given the things you've said.
Okay, we understand that the reason why we're here tonight is we do have the property under contract. We've already We've already invested quite a bit in architectural, as you've had before you, as well as legal fees, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And because we've run into this objection from the staff regarding the setbacks and bringing it up to current code, we wanted to get an idea of which way, more or less, the board would feel or the wind would be blowing before we go further and invest more.
Mm-hmm. Understood. But I think, but just to make sure you understand, you, the board, the committee sitting tonight really didn't give you any feedback at all on the waivers. Okay? They gave you feedback that those are issues you may have to address. What I was trying to convey to you, that's not up to this committee. That's up to the Planning and Zoning Commission and then ultimately the Village Board if it comes back to them.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Coming in front of us.
Okay, number two this evening, request acceptance of Department of Development Services monthly report for Planning Division.
So moved.
I have a motion and a second. Anything you wish to highlight for planning?
Not at this time.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, please take a roll call.
Trustee Palafis. Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
Aye.
Thank you. Number three, request acceptance of Department of Development Services monthly report for Code Enforcement Division.
So moved.
Second.
Anything to highlight in Code Enforcement?
Just that construction permitting activity continues to grow every month, and other than that, nothing.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, please call, take a roll call.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
Aye.
Thank you. Number four, request acceptance of Department of Development Services monthly report for economic development and tourism.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Anything to highlight with economic development? Thank you, Mr. Kramer. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, please call the roll call.
Trustee Palafis. Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
Aye.
President's report is still coming.
Wait for the board meeting.
Is there anything else to come before this committee this evening? Seeing none, I look for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please take the roll call.
Trustee Palafis. Chairman Mills.
Aye.
Vice Chairman Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
We'll take a short recess. Going to be back here by 8:15, a short break. 8:15 promptly, please. We have more business. Can you call the roll, Madam Clerk, to reestablish a quorum?
Trustee Gata.
Present.
Trustee Vandenberg. Trustee Mills.
Present.
Trustee Newell.
Present.
Trustee Stanton.
Present.
Mayor McCloud.
Present. We'll take up where we left off previously. I'd just like to note for the record that this meeting is being broadcast live and will be shown throughout the week on our cable channel. Move on to item number three, recognition of the audience. This is the time if someone has a question or concern they want to bring before the Village Board and the Village staff for an item that's not on the agenda. Now's the time to come forward. Click once, twice, three times, and move on. Chair would accept a motion to approve the minutes of the June 20th, 2016 meeting.
So moved.
Second.
There's a motion. There's a second. Any questions on the minutes? Seeing none, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Vandenberg. I'm sorry. I lied.
Yes.
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Present.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
Aye. Motion carried. I would like to note also for the record that Trustee Palafis is calling in. That's why we're having a roll call on every single item. Move on to item number five, consent agenda. Chair would accept a motion.
So moved.
There's a motion. There's a second. Are there any questions on any of these items? Seeing no questions, can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McCloud.
Aye. Motion carried. We'll go back to President's Report. We already did all the swearing-ins. I'd like to note that Joni and I were pleased to welcome a new granddaughter on July 1st, Violet Helen Duford. We're very happy to have her as a part of the family. I also received a letter from a resident. Dear Bill, I must comment on the wonderful experience I've had as my street and surrounding streets have been upgraded. Our engineering department was so cooperative with giving me information so I could function better while Washington Boulevard was serviced with sewers, curbs, driveways, and sidewalks. The women I talked to within engineering were so polite and helpful. A young man named Andy answered questions politely about upcoming work schedules here and about an old sewer pipe that had been removed. I'm so proud of our Hoffman Estates personnel. Also, one can't help watching the A-lamp workers with their many varied pieces of equipment. I was amazed and edified to watch those workers as they did tree root pruning, concrete removal, curb and gutter repair, my sidewalk, and soon the driveway. Watching them work together was like viewing a well-choreographed stage show. They knew exactly what to do and communicated with each other without a spoken word. Yes, there's someone inconvenient with the dust and not be able to access the drive. That can all be forgotten because of the fine, fine job they've done. Please let our engineering folks, including Andy, know how thankful I am for the expertise and kindness. Sent by one of our residents in Washington. We haven't met in a while. I do have one resignation. Diane Lawrence from the Planning and Zoning Commission. Chair would accept a motion.
So moved with regrets.
Second with regret.
There's a motion, a second. Any discussion? See no discussion. Can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye. Motion carried. On June 29th, I attended Ken Gamal's retirement party. Ken worked for the village for almost 40 years in public works. Also, Wine Wednesday took place in the evening of the 29th at Stone Eagle. On June 30th, President Tony Preckwinkle of the Cook County Board held a roundtable discussion with the local mayors and business leaders at Hanover Township. I want to thank the township for hosting that and County Commissioner Tim Schneider also. We had a great 4th of July Fest, Northwest 4th Fest, and we had great fireworks show on the 3rd, good parade on the 4th, and we were really mobbed with the fireworks. This is the biggest crowd I've ever seen, but everything went very well. The police did a great job of getting everybody out expeditiously that evening, so everything went very well. July 6th, I participated in the Executive Committee meeting of the Northwest Municipal Conference and also attended the Economic Development Commission meeting held here, and the Capital Improvements Board meeting held in the evening. On July 7th, I attended the Tax Increment Financing and EDA Joint Review Board meetings. Mm-hmm. And on July 9th, several of us went to the Sri Jalaram Mandir for their grand reopening. There were thousands of people there. It was really quite a crowd. We had Trustees Gata and Newell and Stanton also came along. This morning, I attended the WINGS Leadership Board meeting. And this evening, we had a reception for the three police officers who were promoted. Congratulations to all of them. Well-deserved, and I know they will do an outstanding job. At this point, I'll turn it over to Trustee Comments. Let's start with Trustee Palafis.
I just want to echo the congratulations for our three officers. And that's all for me, sir. Thank you.
Great. Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. On Wednesday, the 22nd of June, we, I think most of us attended the Northwest Municipal Conference, the dinner and gala at the Meridian Banquet Hall. It was a very nice affair. On the 2nd of July, Trustee Mills and I did the beer sales, the tickets, and it was fun to see a lot of people out there that we knew, and we were pretty busy in the beginning, and it was a beautiful day. On July 2nd, and then, of course, the 3rd at the Northwest 4th Fest with the fireworks. The fireworks were fabulous. I have heard from so many residents that just really enjoyed the entire 4th Fest, but especially the fireworks. They were really, really good. The entertainment was good. The parade was great the next day. A lot of people that came out to see the parade, and it's always nice to see other residents. I'd like to say congratulations to the officers on their promotions that happened today. I'd also like to congratulate the McLeod family on the birth of Violet Helen. Beautiful name, Violet. Beautiful pictures on Facebook, social media, and she'll be a welcome addition to your family, I'm sure.
Thank you.
I'd like to encourage everybody to sign up for the Plotz Concert 5K run. It's now active on active.com, and you can go and register, find out more information about the run. And lastly, I'd like to say congratulations to my son and my daughter-in-law on their 7th wedding anniversary today.
Good. Congratulations. Move on to Trustee Stanton.
Thank you. On the 21st of June, I was able to attend the ice cream social and bingo event put on by the Senior Citizens Commission. And I want to thank them because it was a wonderful event. And they had Dairy Queen ice cream, which was pretty
good,
delicious.
Wow.
Yes, many of us had it. On the 22nd of June, I was able to attend the Northwest Municipal Conference Gala event, and I was glad that we were inside because that rain that night was tremendous. I know a lot of places flooded out as we were coming home, and we had to go around the water. On the 26th of June, I got to the CAC event. I got there about 10:05, which was a little late, but I did get there, and I wanted to support everybody and stayed for a little while. And then the 4th of July parade, I was able to walk in that, and I want to thank everybody that was involved in the 4th of July, the 4th of July Commission, and all the volunteers that made it such a successful event. On the 6th of July, I attended the Capital Improvements Board, their mid-year review. On the 9th of July, I attended the Sri Jaram Mandir Invocation Ceremony. And I want to congratulate the officers that were promoted tonight and also to the McLeod family for their addition.
Thank you. Trustee Mills.
Thank you. I also was pleased to be a part of the retirement luncheon for Ken Gamal, who retired after almost 40 years. It was really great. I think his wife had the best line of the day, though. What was it? Goodbye tension, hello pension. So that was a cute one to come out with.
And don't say that in front of the newspaper.
Yeah. And also on Friday of that week, Clerk Romanoff and I attended the retirement for Lieutenant Tom Sullivan, which was one of the reasons that we had our promotions tonight. It's because of Tom retiring. Wish them both of them well in their new journeys in life. A lot of congratulations, one to the McLeod family on their new addition, and especially one to the officers that were promoted this evening, and a thank you to all of our officers for all the great job they do. Given the circumstances over the last week or so, it's not easy being a police officer, and we thank you for your job. And a special thanks to the 4th of July Commission and all of the various volunteers that signed up to help out. I know Ken out in the audience was a great helper during that last weekend, too, to help out and get involved. And you did a great job to all the committee. We do appreciate all the time and effort that went into the whole weekend. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Mills. Trustee Newell.
Okay, moving right along here. The 22nd, as Trustee Stanton said, we had the huge rain event. So the 23rd and the 7th were the days that the Village Green had their concerts, and the weather was very, very nice. So a little chilly on the 23rd, but and enjoyable. So thank you to the Arts Commission. Very, very nice. On the 26th, attended the block party on Chatham and also did the CAC walk. And on the 2nd, attended the craft fair. Had to kind of keep roaming around looking at great things, a lot of crafters. And then, of course, the 4th of July parade, attended that. And I want to just say thank you to everyone who volunteered, the commission, all the planning that goes into it, and all the hard work to make it such a good event for all the community and all the people to enjoy to get together. On the 6th, of course, the mid-year CIB meeting, and on the 9th, several of us, as the mayor had mentioned, attended the Sri Jalaram Mandir, which was their invocation ceremony. Today, of course, the sustainability meeting, and congratulations to all the police for their promotions, Lieutenant Golden, Sergeant Goldbeck, and Sergeant Savage. And last but not least, congratulations to Violet and to Mayor and Mrs. becoming Grandpa and Grandma again.
Thank you. Trustee Gaeta.
Yes, bringing up the rear on that. As far as the ice cream social and the galley banquet that we went to and the block party, on Chatham and so forth. Then on Wednesday, the 29th, we attended the Wine Wednesday at Stone Eagle. And then for the Fourth Fest, Johanna and I were working for the wristbands, and I had these people that were coming up that were, I'm 73 years old. You mean you want to? Anyways, enough of that. Walked in the Hoffman Estates parade with all of us, attended the Haverford Place homeowners meeting. Then on Wednesday, the 6th, the Capital Improvements Board that we met here. Then Saturday, as the mayor and some of the trustees, the Shari Shalom Mander invocation ceremony. And yes, I'll bet there was at least almost 3,000 people that were there. And they greeted us so welcomely when we walked in the door. They made us feel that welcome to go in. And they even honored us by giving us a bouquet of flowers. And the Hindu priest said a prayer for each one that they gave the flowers to, which I really thought was very moving. Anyways, and then tonight, no question about it, as far as congratulations to Lieutenant Golden, Sergeant Goldbeck, and Sergeant Savage. That's all, and congratulations to you and Joni. Right?
Thank you.
That's it.
All righty, move on to 6C, Village Manager's Report.
Just one thing to add, and I know if Trustee Plofis was sitting here, he would mention it, and that's this coming Thursday night out at the Village Green, Pamela Rose, and the Windy City Country.
Very good. Okay, 6D, Village Clerk's Report.
Okay, I got a couple of things. My usual, 81 passports and 150. Fuck air.
Was that a motion?
That was for me to shut up. 81 passports and 152 FOIAs were through the village during the month of June. And Cook County's clerk's office has asked us all to promote becoming election judges for the upcoming election. They're expecting huge turnouts, and I think they want 21 or 22 machines here in our village hall. So it's going to be packed, and I don't know how they're going to staff it. So there's flyers out in the hallway there if somebody's interested, or go on Cook County Clerk website and read some information on there. Hopefully we'll get some extra people. They're going to need it big time.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Madam Clerk. Move on to 6C Committee Reports, Public Health and Safety, Trustee Gaeta.
Yes, Public Health and Safety, we will meet on July 18th, 2016, here in the boardroom. We will have a roll call, approval of the minutes of June 27, 2016. Under new business, we have five items. Number one, request approval of ordinance amending sections 2-8-2-1-8-8-15 of the Village of Hoffman Estates Municipal Code pertaining to the licensing and operation of pet shops and kennels. And two, request acceptance of the Police Department monthly report. Three, request acceptance of the Health Human Services monthly report. Four, request acceptance of the Emergency Management Coordinator monthly report. And five, request acceptance of the Fire Department monthly report. We will have a President's report if there's anything in other or items in review, and we will adjourn.
Thank you, Trustee Gaeta. Finance Committee, Trustee Plofis, do you want to handle that, or do you want Trustee Newell to do it?
He says Trustee
Newell. Trustee Newell can do it.
Okay.
Okay, I don't sound like Palafis, but I'll try. Immediately following the Public Health and Safety, we will have the Finance Committee on July 18th. We will have a roll call. We will have the approval of minutes for June 27, 2016. And under new business, we have five items. Item number one will be request approval of a resolution establishing higher back rates for police personnel for the period July 1st, 2016, through December 31st, 2016. Item number two, request authorization to extend the master service agreement with Sentinel Technologies Incorporated to provide hardware and software support for the village's telephone and voicemail system and the Village of Hoffman Estates for 1 year in an amount not to exceed $28,710. Item number three is request acceptance of Finance Department monthly report. Four is request acceptance of Information System Department monthly report. And five is request acceptance of Sears Center monthly report. If there will be any additional items for the president, nothing under other, no items in review, and then we will adjourn.
Thank you. Public Works and Utilities, Trustee Newell.
Okay, so immediately following finance on the 18th of July, we will have the Public Works and Utility Committee. We'll have a roll call, approval of minutes from June 27, 2016. And under new business, we have four items. Item number one will be discussion regarding Emerald Ash Borer update. Item number two will be request authorization to award contract for the 2016 Drainage Improvements Project, bid to be announced. Item number three will be request acceptance of the Department of Public Works monthly report. Item four will be request acceptance of the Department of Development Services monthly engineering report of the Transportation and Engineering Division. If there's anything additional under President's report, nothing under other items in review, and we will adjourn.
Thank you, Trustee Newell. Move on to item number seven, Planning and Zoning Commission report with the ever-patient Chairperson Eva Combs.
The Planning and Zoning Commission recommended for approval a request by Poplar Creek Crossing LLC owner and Heroic Fitness LLC tenant for a special use under section 9-8-3-B-3 of the zoning code to permit a health and fitness club on the property located at 2626 North Sutton Road in Poplar Creek Crossing Shopping Center with two conditions. There were 11 A's, 0 nays.
Move to accept.
Is there a second?
Second.
There's a motion, a second. Any questions on this end? Trustee Stanton.
They already were operating for 2 years, right?
Yes, this is just a recommendation by staff to bring them into compliance with the rest of the fitness clubs.
Were they in compliance was something had to be done?
No, nothing had to be done. It was just that we hadn't classified them appropriately and therefore needed a special use permit.
Okay, thank you.
Anyone else have any questions? Seeing none, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Mm-hmm. Trustee Palafis?
Aye.
Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
Aye.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Motion carried.
Zoning Commission recommended for approval a request by Hoffman Estates Medical Development LLC owner for a site plan amendment for site improvement and special use under section 9-5-11-G-12 of the zoning code to permit the National Archives and Records Administration tenant to operate a temporary archive and storage facility on the property located at 2500 West Gulf Road with 14 conditions. Vote was 11 A's, 0 nays.
Chair would accept a motion.
So moved.
Second. There's a motion, there's a second. Are there any questions on this item? Trustee Mills.
Yeah, petitioners present.
Can someone come up?
Someone can speak for the petitioner.
Some questions.
I know.
If you can identify yourselves for the record, sir.
Sure. Good evening. Alexander Draposky, counsel for the owner.
Just one quick question. There, I see that we have like 14 conditions on here. And just for the record, does the petitioner agree to abide by all 14 conditions?
Well, we have a question about one.
Which one?
Okay, can you identify yourself for the record, ma'am?
Ann Brown, counsel for the petitioner.
Which is the item you're concerned about?
5C, which states the plan sheet should be revised to change the striped areas in the eastern perimeter of the parking lot to curb landscape islands.
And the question?
Well, we're all in favor of curb landscape islands.
Okay.
If we do that, however, that will preclude two delivery trucks from being parked in the back. That will allow only one delivery truck to enter and exit. And the tenant has requested for there to be two delivery bays open.
How does staff, did this come up during the meeting at all with Plan Commission?
It was not.
No, it was never
addressed. Oh, it should have been addressed at that point.
Yeah. Well, it's your responsibility, and perhaps we didn't comprehend what this meant until we saw it in the drawing subsequent to the zoning meeting. And then we saw that it would not be possible to have two trucks back there.
Peter, can I ask a question?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Is there a way to accommodate the two trucks with Only a portion of the island's being done?
I think so. Actually, when I look at the, the petitioner plan set does include a truck turning template, and I guess I'm not clear if a truck is actually parked at the warehouse bays and sitting there. I'm not quite, I don't see any conflict for a second truck to be able to maneuver. We don't have a, I guess I don't have any information that really shows what the issue is. If there appears to be an excess of space, so I'm not quite clear on.
Can you speak into the microphone, sir?
Sergey.
It's a public meeting. We can't have a sidebar here.
Absolutely, Mayor. Absolutely. We brought with us the architect. He can better address this. Please
identify. Just identify yourself.
My name is Sergey Sapon, the architect on the project. After we received the comments from zoning board, we resend that proposal to civil engineers, and they run AutoTurn software that determines the truck turning distances. It is true that the, I would like to mention that the truck parking or parking in front of the loading docks is existing. So we're not proposing anything new. We just would like to keep it at the same configuration as it exists right now. So that's the main point, I guess. So the certain area in front of the truck loading docks were shown as hedged or, marked as hedged on the civil engineering drawings. That area was recommended to be curbed island. We would like to keep it just striped, striped as a striped no park zone instead of changing the curb. That's the only condition that we would like to change out of the conditions that were requested by the village.
Mr. Gugliotta, do you have any sort of response on this, or?
Striped area all the way on the eastern portion of the plan?
It's the diagonal area there that
63 feet.
Roughly, okay. 63 feet.
Where it says 63 feet? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. And we think there can be a, and looking at a compromise.
Okay.
But we it, maybe the condition could be revised so we could work on this in the field to come up with an optimum solution.
It's hard to provide a definitive answer on this. I mean, there appears that there's still some areas that could be landscaped. But again, it's hard to tell from these drawings. There's two options. We could potentially some semblance of an island could be put to really only make sure that it's the necessary area that's striped. The other alternative would be to look at some type of a mountable, like a rolled 3-inch curb that would be a mountable area where a typical car would be defined so people wouldn't just be driving there or parking there randomly.
Right.
Generally, obviously, our standards are to not use striping for paved areas that are unnecessary. So if its only purpose is, and they have it presented their project as having very, very infrequent deliveries other than the initial move-in period, we really try to avoid having paved areas that are not necessary be striped. It really should either be landscaping or some other kind of treatment. But there are probably alternatives, compromise solutions we could look at.
I think the other thing
it's going to require some additional evaluation.
What would you recommend? That one condition be pulled at this point? Or somehow be amended to say pending staff?
Probably the latter. If we can modify it to allow, I guess, defer for a staff analysis to try and determine a solution with the petitioner.
Yeah, maybe through agreement between the
I don't want to see this going back to planning.
Planning department and the petitioner.
Yeah.
Is that a motion, Trustee Mills?
Yes, it is.
I'll second it. Let me ask you this question, though. As far as you're saying there's two trucks, are these two trucks going to be there all day long, all the time?
Trustee Gata, if I could, I'm looking at the schematics that Mr. Gugliotta has. It's actually the turning movements of the trucks in and out, the radiuses. Yeah. So if one truck is sitting in the dock and the other one is trying to get in there, it has to move wider, and it would go into this landscaped area. Mm-hmm. based upon what those plans show, which are slightly different than the ones they have in you. These are really the building plans. Okay. So they actually put the radiuses more fully on the plans.
As compared to what we have.
As compared to what you have. And that's why when we just conferred, it looks like about 50% or less is going to be impacted by the turning radiuses. And so we would need to look at this a little bit in the field to fix it.
Okay.
I think the other thing to point out is that while it is the village's goal always to bring the properties up to current standards, as we talked about with the previous courtesy review, this is a six-year special use.
Right.
This is a temporary use. This isn't something that, from a village standpoint, whoever comes in next is going to be different. That end by the loading docks will be different. So it's really up to the board. If you want to have a portion of that landscaped, we can work on figuring out. If you want to just waive that requirement, since it's that side of the building near the loading docks, I could see that as well.
You're next to a retention pond. It's
agreed.
Not like it's going right. to be anything that visible.
Agreed.
Just to point out, there are other, at the north end of that row of parking, there is another area that mm-hmm. should be changed and really is not an issue with the truck turning at all.
Striped area.
Yeah,
Do you understand that part of it? Do you have any problems with that part?
Yes, I believe those areas were changed on the new plans.
Okay, this plan that you just handed me? Yes. Okay, I see that.
So it's just the 63-foot area.
That area's now been corrected?
Yes, Mr. they did Googly note that on. Yes, they did note that okay. on these new plans.
So it's just the 63 feet area.
Yes.
Okay, we do have a motion and a second. Yeah. What's the
question? The question still remains: should we just take out 5C?
Well, I think the 5C is important in that part of the area they did address through these plans. So there were two areas that would have to have landscape islands put around them. They correct on the plans that we have. They did it with one. They're appealing the other. We don't have a problem either way with that second one. Whether if you wanted to do part of it or you want to eliminate it, you can eliminate it. If you want to leave this just to add it where the staff can work with the petitioner on this issue, then we're probably there.
That's fine with
all
me.
Right.
Yeah, just leave.
Okay, we do have a motion.
Eva, is that okay with you? Where is she? Yeah, okay. You feel the plan, your commission would be all right with that, too?
Yes.
Okay.
We do have a motion and a second. Can we have a roll call on the amendment?
Palafis?
No.
Yo.
No. Is that a no or a yo?
Trustee Gata?
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Yes.
Trustee Mills?
Yes.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Motion carried. Now we have the main motion.
Now, you don't have a problem with any other conditions, though, correct?
Other than that one, no.
Perfect. Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Took me off guard by saying
so I understand.
Yes.
Did we just vote?
That was on the
motion.
That
was just an amendment.
Now I have to vote on the main motion.
As amended.
As amended.
That was the amendment to delete 5C from the condition.
No, it wasn't to delete it.
Not deleted
it.
With the staff.
Which we're happy to do. Would that delay anything?
No.
Okay. No, it's not going to delay anything.
Not at all.
Matter of fact, if you wait 5 minutes, we'll talk to you after the meeting.
Okay. We do have a motion a second. Any further discussion? Seeing none, can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis?
No.
Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
Aye.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Motion carried. Thank you, gentlemen. If you want to hang around, you can speak with Mr. Gugliata and Mr. Norris when the meeting is over. Move on to eight additional business. Let's take these one at a time.
Mm-hmm.
Request board approval of an ordinance granting a special use to Hoffman Estates Medical Development, LLC owner, 2500 West Gulf Road, National Archives and Records Administration. Chair, accept a motion.
So moved.
Second.
There's a second. Any discussion on this item? See no discussion. Can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis.
No.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye. Motion carried. 8B, request board approval to dispose of village records that have exceeded their state required retention period.
So moved.
Second.
Motion second.
Any discussion on this one? Seeing none, can you call the roll, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye. Motion carried. 8C, request board approval of request by Verizon Wireless for an extension to an existing cellular antenna license at 95 Astor Lane, item deferred, see minutes of June 20th, 2016. Where are we at on this item?
Is it ready to go forward?
It's ready to go forward.
Ready to go forward?
I'll make the motion.
There's a motion, there's a second. Any questions on this item? Seeing none, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis?
No.
Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
Aye.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Motion carried. Move on to 8D. Request board reconsideration request by Petro Auto LLC owner for a site plan amendment for site improvements on the property located at 1300 West Higgins Road.
Also make a motion.
Okay, Village Board supports a motion to reconsider petition request this item be remanded to the Planning and Zoning Commission. There is a motion and there is a second. Is there any discussion on this? Seeing no discussion, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis?
Aye.
Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
No.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye. Motion carried. Chair, accept the motion.
Was that the motion to reconsider?
That's to reconsider.
That's the motion to reconsider. Right. Now the matter is before the board.
Yes.
Right. No. No, no.
Yes. Remanded to the.
No.
Someone needs to make that motion.
Yeah, somebody has to make the motion to remand it.
Remand has to be a separate motion.
Yeah. I'll make a motion to remand this to Planning and Zoning Commission for, I don't know what, the third time.
There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a motion. There's a second. More work for you, Chairperson Combs, potentially. Is there any further discussion on this? Seeing none, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis?
No.
Man, you guys are killing me. Trustee Gata?
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg?
Aye.
Trustee Mills?
No.
Trustee Newell?
Aye.
Trustee Stanton?
Aye.
Mayor McLeod?
Aye.
Motion carried. Now, Chair, accept a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
So moved.
Second.
There's a motion. There's a second. Any discussion on this one?
I heard a third and a fourth.
Seeing none, can you pull the board, Madam Clerk?
Trustee Palafis.
Aye.
Trustee Gata.
Aye.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Aye.
Trustee Mills.
Aye.
Trustee Newell.
Aye.
Trustee Stanton.
Aye.
Mayor McLeod.
Aye. Motion carried. We are adjourned.